Hello friends, welcome to Best Tutor. This is Rama Vishwanathan. In today's video, we're going to learn about cyclic quadrilateral. What is a cyclic quadrilateral? What are its properties? Quadrilateral, we have already dealt with. A quadrilateral is a closed figure bounded by four line segments. Then what does this word cyclic mean? Cyclic quadrilateral. A quadrilateral whose all vertices lie on a circle is called as a cyclic quadrilateral. For example, this is a circle and A, B, C, D. These are the four points on the circle, and if I join them, I am going to get a quadrilateral. So such a quadrilateral is called as a cyclic quadrilateral. So what are its properties? The first property of a cyclic quadrilateral is opposite angles are supplementary. Supplementary and complementary, these are the two terms which are based on angles. Two angles are said to be supplementary if their sum is equal to 180 degrees. If the sum of the measures of two angles is equal to 180, I call those angles as supplementary angles. Similarly, if the sum of the measures of two angles is equal to 90 degrees, then they are said to be complementary angles. Now, in this theorem, it states that opposite angles of a cyclic quadrilateral are supplementary. What is the basic property of a quadrilateral? Sum of all the four angles is equal to 360 degrees. That's it. Now here, because it is a cyclic quadrilateral, I need to prove that these two angles, they are supplementary. That means angle ADC plus angle ABC is equal to 180 degrees, or angle DAB plus angle DCB is equal to 180 degrees. Let us consider this pair of angles. If this is proved, that can be proved automatically, similarly. Okay, how are we going to prove it? This is a circle, so it will have a center. Right, circle has a center O. Let me join OA and OC. Right, AOC is the angle made by this arc at the center. Let me assume that this is A, and angle AOC is equal to A. That implies angle ADC is equal to half of it. Isn't it? Angle made by the arc at the center is twice the angle made by the same arc at any point on the circumference of the circle. So if this is A, this should be A by 2. Right? Okay. Now, this is A. Let me assume that this angle is B. Reflex angle of angle AOC. Then what is the angle pertaining to, corresponding to angle AOC, it is going to be angle ABC. This will be B by 2 by using the same property that angle subtended by an arc at the center is twice the angle made by the same arc at any point on the remaining part of the circle. If I consider this angle B, I am considering this arc. Then this is the arc AC. This arc is making an angle B at the center. Then what is the angle made by the same arc at any point on the remaining part of the circle? Angle ABC. So this is B, this is B by 2. I hope this is clear. Now, angle AOC is equal to A, angle reflex angle AOC is equal to B. But sum of the angles around a point is equal to 360 degrees because it's going to be a complete angle. This implies A plus B is equal to 360 degrees. Isn't it? Sum of the angles at any at a point, around a point, is equal to 360 degrees. I divide the entire equation by 2. A plus B by 2 is equal to 360 by 2. This implies A by 2 plus B by 2 is equal to 180 degrees, right? I have split the fraction. But what is A by 2? Angle ADC. Similarly, B by 2 is angle ABC. Angle ADC plus angle ABC is equal to 180 degrees. That means we have proved that opposite angles of a cyclic quadrilateral are supplementary. I repeat the proof. I have considered a cyclic quadrilateral ABCD. That means all the four vertices of the quadrilateral are on the circle. on the circle, right? Now I have to prove ABC plus angle ADC is equal to 180 degrees. I consider the center of the circle O. Then I join A to O and C to O. We have got an angle made by this arc AC at the center. By using the property, angle property, that is angle made by an arc at the center is twice the angle made by the same arc at any point on the remaining part of the circle. Therefore, angle ADC is A by 2. If this angle is A, then the reflex angle, I have assumed it to be B. Then this angle is going to be B by 2 by using the same property. Now, A plus B is equal to 360 degrees because they are angles around a point. And complete angle is equal to 360 degrees. So, A plus B is equal to 360. I divided the entire equation by 2. So, A plus B by 2 is equal to 360 by 2. A by 2 plus B by 2 is equal to 180 degrees. A by 2 is angle ADC. B by 2 is angle ABC. So, angle ADC plus angle ABC is equal to 180 degrees. That means opposite angles of a cyclic quadrilateral are supplementary. I can also prove similarly that angle DCB plus angle DAB is equal to 180 degrees. Now, moving on to the next property of the cyclic quadrilateral. The next property is exterior angle of a cyclic quadrilateral is equal to its interior opposite angle. What does it mean? I have a circle and I drew a quadrilateral on it. This is a quadrilateral. Now I extend this line. Then this becomes the exterior angle. A, B, C, D is the cyclic quadrilateral. It is a cyclic quadrilateral because all the four vertices are on the circle. This is a point E. Now we need to prove that exterior angle of a cyclic quadrilateral is equal to its interior opposite angles is equal to its interior opposite angle. That means we need to prove that angle CBE is equal to angle ADC. This is to be proved. How are we going to prove it? What is given? A cyclic quadrilateral, an exterior angle. What is to be proved? Angle BCE, that is the exterior angle, is equal to its interior opposite angle. What should be our approach? Let us consider. Just now we have proved that opposite angles of a cyclic quadrilateral are supplementary. Let me assume that this angle is A and this angle is B and this angle is C. I need to prove A is equal to C. We are going to prove it very comfortably, very simple proof. We know that A plus B is equal to 180 degrees. Opposite angles of a cyclic quadrilateral. Just now we have proved that they are supplementary. Now consider the straight line AB. This is a point on the straight line and these two are two angles at the point on the straight line. B plus C is equal to 180 degrees because it is a linear pair. Right? Very simple. There we are done. Sum of these two angles is equal to 180. Sum of these two angles is equal to 180. These two equations have the same RHS. Therefore, left hand side should be the same. A plus B is equal to B plus C or A is equal to C. This implies angle ADC is equal to angle CBE. Very simple proof. So in this video we have proved two statements. One, opposite angles of a cyclic quadrilateral are supplementary. Two, exterior angle of a cyclic quadrilateral is equal to its interior opposite angle. And both the theorems we have proved making use of one simple concept, that is angle subtended by the arc at the center is equal to twice the angle subtended by the same arc at any point on the circumference of the circle. Using the first property, I proved the second property. So, these are the two properties of cyclic quadrilaterals. In the coming videos, we are going to learn many more properties of circles. Thank you.